Ms. Paul, this is Dr. Marion. Dr. Marion, Ms.
Very
Paul.
Pleased to meet you, and thank you for your speech. I'm representing the 3 and 4 campaign. I want to know how we're going to deal with the long-term care health issues here in America, especially since we have a geriatric tsunami heading this way.
Well, I'll tell you, you know, the agreement I made with my husband was that I would take care of the family and he would take care of the country. So I probably am not the one that could answer your question to the very best. It is a problem, and we have to do it. One thing we have to do is we have to get our families oriented to the fact that they are a family and they should be taking care of their family if they can to the best of their ability. And then if they cannot, then someone else has to take it from there. But I can take it that far. You know, sometimes now the family just says, we don't need to take care of them. They can go to a home and the government will pay for it. Well, who is the government? The government is you and me and all the other people in the world. And are we allowed to take money from people and give it to someone else without permission? I don't think so. I know it is a problem. I would be sure that Ron would have ideas and ways that we could take care of it. Some of the ways that we could take care of it would be, you know, we still have people in, I forget how many countries, but way more than just Iraq and Afghanistan. We still have people in Korea. We still have people in Germany. We still have people in Japan. And we're paying them, and they're spending their money over there.
Instead of talking about Americans who are stationed there for whatever the reasons.
Right, right. They're still stationed there, and we finished the wars. You know, since we got out of Vietnam, they said, oh, it'll be taken over by the communists. But, you know, now they've gotten more Western. They trade with us. And we should be able to bring some of those men home, do great things in the United States. You know, we take care of the borders overseas, but what about the borders of the American America? People care about those borders here, and we're having a problem because people come across those borders and they expect us to send their, educate their children, feed them, give them Social Security. Now, how can we do that when they're not even paying into it, nor have they paid into it? And I'm not saying that we should cut off all immigration and everything, but there are ways to do it. And some of the ways would be bringing these men home and not spending that money. Also, we're building a huge facility, embassy in Iran, bigger than the Vatican. Do the American people want their money taken from them to build an embassy over there? This is America. We want our money spent in America, and that would help take care of your problem.
So on long-term care insurance, how can the Republican Party or your husband help so that the average American can finance or at least start to finance their own long-term health issues?
Would be to bring some of the jobs home, have more, and the way they can bring some of the jobs home is the fact that they've gone over there because we put too many regulations. And so the companies can't make money here in the United States because they can go over there and don't have to pay a lot of different taxes that they have to pay here. So they're going there, and our manufacturing is almost nothing. So if we would let those people come back without a tax or a penalty, they might bring some of our manufacturing back to the United States. We would have more jobs and more money to take care of these people. And people might be able to, there are a number of ways that we can think to help these people. And there are people in need, but we have to use our head. We can't just throw dollars out the window because, frankly, we don't have that many dollars to send.
Well, thank you so much.
You're
I appreciate
welcome.
The time.
You're welcome.